To watch the latest from India Science, don't forget to subscribe to the channel and press on the bell icon to get notifications on all the science-related videos.
Though Venus is the second planet from our Sun, it is the hottest in the solar system, with temperatures reaching 464 degrees Celsius. Making Venus a furnace is the greenhouse effect. About 96% of the atmosphere is carbon dioxide, a potent heat-trapping gas. At an altitude of 40 to 60 km from the surface are sulfuric acid clouds. On Earth, clouds are primarily water. Our neighbor's atmospheric pressure on the surface of Venus is 90 times that of the Earth's. Though the two planets are widely different, Earth and Venus have similar mass and size. As a result, they're often called twins. Studies suggest that Venus might also have plate tectonics, which on Earth are responsible for quakes, volcanism, and the formation of mountains. Further, some scientists believe our neighbor was a lot like Earth in the past, with oceans and habitable surface temperatures for up to 2 billion years of its early history. And then suddenly, something changed. Oceans began evaporating, becoming water vapor in the atmosphere. Water vapor, as you might know, is a greenhouse gas. It traps heat and increases surface temperature, further inducing oceans to evaporate and release more water vapor as a result. This cycle might have caused Venus to experience a runaway greenhouse effect, thereby suffering a fate different from Earth. Despite the hostile conditions, some speculate that life could have taken off in the clouds of Venus. Bringing the theory back to life was a recent study that detected phosphine in the clouds. On Earth, the chemical can be traced back to biological sources, leading some to believe that the atmosphere of Venus could host life. However, other studies have called these findings into question. NASA is preparing two missions that can settle the debate. It will also answer questions on the planet's history and why it is so different from Earth. NASA's missions to Venus are: an orbiter named Veritas will map the planet's surface. Its job is to confirm whether plate tectonics and volcanism are active on Venus. Da Vinci Plus is a spacecraft that will plunge into Venus's atmosphere and measure the concentration of noble gases and other elements to understand why the atmosphere has a runaway greenhouse effect compared to Earth. In addition, it will test whether the planet ever hosted a liquid ocean. Both of them are expected to launch between 2028 and 2030. Europe will also send an orbiter to Venus sometime in 2030. Named Envision, it will also study our neighbor's history, if the planet continues to have active plate tectonics, and why climate change altered it. These are not the first missions to Venus. In 1970, the former Soviet Union's Venera 7 became the first spacecraft to soft land on Venus. It stayed active for 23 minutes before the heat could kill it. NASA has had two orbiters around Venus, Pioneer Venus 1 launched in 1978 and Magellan in 1989. The European Space Agency launched Venus Express in 2005 and it operated until 2014. Currently, JAXA's Okhotsky is in orbit.